So during our preparation, okay, there are like for each subject there will be what we call most important topic, which is frequently repeated. Okay, so you take what we call anatomy. From anatomy, a joint is a must, be a shoulder, hip, okay, or a knee joint. Similarly, if you take forensic medicine, in the forensic medicine, examination of rape, victim of sexual assault for the last 4 or 5 years, it's a frequent question. Similarly, when it comes to physiology, what I observed is like the physiology of sleep or sleep physiology is one of very important topic. Okay, so please focus. So in this video, I'll be discussing the definition and the neurophysiology, and also what are the physiological changes which occur during the sleep when it comes to heart rate, BP, respiration, how they change. I'll also give you what are the different types or stages of sleep. Types means we have REM and non-REM sleep. Stages means in that we have 5 stages. And what is the sleep cycle? Okay, how it is spaced, and also what are the variations of the sleep cycle according to the age? So as we age, what happens to our sleep cycle? What is the difference of sleep cycle in an infant with an adult? So we'll be looking into that aspects. Followed by very important thing, we know that electroencephalography, EEG, it depicts the waveforms which are electrical potentials which are generated in the brain cells. Okay, so I'll be teaching you what are the normal adult brain waves, and also what happens during an awake stage, and what happens during both a non-REM and REM sleeps. Okay, and at the end, let us also add some insights into understanding different disorders associated with sleep. Okay, so these are the headings under which I'll be discussing this very important topic, that is sleep physiology. So the definition is simple. Sleep is a natural periodic state of rest. Okay, it gives rest for both mind and body, wherein we close our eyes. Plus, not just closing eyes and taking rest is sleep. There should be either partial or, more importantly, complete loss of consciousness. So what is sleep? It is natural periodic state of rest for mind and body with closed eyes, characterized by partial or complete loss of consciousness. Okay, so define sleep is done. What is the mechanism behind sleep? Okay, how sleep is induced? So for sleep induction, there are sleep centers in the brain. So there are two sleep centers. One is the raphe nucleus, which is located in the lower pons and medulla. The other is locus coeruleus, which is located in the pons. Whenever these sleep centers activated, they induce sleep. Okay, you take an example of raphe nucleus. When it is activated, it leads to secretion of serotonin. And whenever serotonin is secreted with the help of raphe nucleus, it induces non-rapid eye movement sleep. Okay, whereas upon stimulation of locus coeruleus, it releases noradrenaline, and this induces REM sleep or rapid eye movement sleep. These are activating centers. For maintaining wakefulness, consciousness, one of the important structure in the brain is reticular activating system. Okay, ascending pathways, they are responsible for the wakefulness, and they have connection with higher centers, that is cerebral cortex. When these are inhibited, this induces sleep, and when they are irreversibly what we call inhibited, that leads to deep sleep and coma. Okay, so these are the two brain centers which cause activation and inhibition. Okay, so this is the mechanism behind sleep. Let us quickly see what are the physiological changes that occur during sleep. Heart rate comes down, BP initially comes down, then it is maintained flat, but if there is a sudden dream, okay, disturbing sleep disturbance because of dreams, which is a scary dream, it leads to pressure elevation. Okay, and even sleep disturbances cause chronic elevation of the blood pressure. That it happens in case of obstructive sleep apnea. What happens there? Because of the sleep disturbances, patient will also develop hypertension. Okay, one of the factor. And when it comes to respiration, respiratory rate comes down. Okay, and force also decreases. It might become irregular, giving rise to a specific pattern. That is Cheney-Stokes type of periodic breathing. Cheney-Stokes. There is another variety called Kussmaul's. Kussmaul's breathing. Okay. But this here we have a Cheney-Stokes breathing. Kussmaul breathing is characteristic of diabetic ketoacidosis. Okay. So where you will see an irregular breathing pattern like this, you will see only hyperapnea. Whereas Cheney-Stokes breathing is seen in sleep, okay, deep sleep, and you will see hyperapnea, hypopnea followed by apneic episodes. Then hypopnea, hyperapnea followed by apneic episodes. You will have mix of both apnea and hyperapnea. Whereas in Kussmaul's breathing, which is seen in diabetic ketoacidosis, you will see cyclical breathing, because even diabetic ketoacidosis is also an important topic in medicine. Okay, so you need to understand the difference between these respiratory patterns, and your take home is Cheney-Stokes is seen in sleep, Kussmaul's is seen in diabetes. So this much is more than enough. What happens to secretions during sleep? There are different kinds of secretions. You take example of saliva. Salivary secretion decreases. You take gastric secretions, they slightly increase, okay, and on empty stomach they increase more and they cause peristalsis. Wherever urine decreases, wet increases, and lacrimal secretions they decrease. Okay, and next is what happens to the muscle tone during the sleep. There is sleep paralysis, so tone of all the muscles of the body decreases except ocular muscles, because there is a sleep called rapid eye movement sleep, where the muscles need muscles help in movement of the eyeball, right? So that's the reason the tone of all the muscles in the body decreases except eye muscles. And we all know that Babinski's sign is positive in upper motor neuron lesions plus infancy due to impaired development or improper myelination of the tracts plus deep sleep, because in deep sleep also the Babinski's sign becomes positive. And when it comes to reflexes, okay, reflexes, what happens? The for threshold of the most of the reflexes increases, so they come down, okay, and also all of them come down except Babinski's. Okay, Babinski's is positive, and pupils they are constructed, but light reflex is intact, okay, during the sleep, and there will be some eyeball movements. These are few physiological changes which are important and which occur during sleep. Next is, what are the different stages or types of sleep? When I say types of sleep, we all know that we have the predominant component is non-rapid eye movement sleep followed by REM sleep. This non-rapid eye movement sleep is divided into four stages, stage 1, 2, 3, 4. REM, we call it as stage 5. 70 to 80% is NREM, okay. 20 to 30% is REM. Among this, it is subdivided again. Okay, stage 1 is less, stage 2 is 2 to 15%, stage 2 is of 15%, stage 3 is 12%, and stage 4 is 13%. Okay, among the parameters, they constitute most of the sleep. Actually, it is not 15, this is 45. The bulk of the what we call NREM sleep is formed by stage 2. Okay, so stage 2 is 45%, please. So this is how it is divided. Okay, so these are simple differences between NREM and REM sleep. About rapid eye movement, they are absent and they are present. It is simple to understand. What about dreams? What about consolidation of memory? Dreams, consolidation of memory, and twitching of the muscle because of the tone, they are all because of REM sleep. They occur in the REM sleep. They are not seen in non-REM sleep. Similarly, fluctuation of vitals occurs during REM sleep. And during the mechanism of sleep, I told you, what is that? Raphe nucleus, serotonin is NREM, and locus coeruleus, noradrenaline is REM sleep. And what about EEG pattern? One thing is simple. During NREM sleep, so we have shift from awake stage to NREM stage, and this slowly goes into REM stage. Okay. Awake and REM sleep, they are synchronized. They are similar. Desynchronization of these waves occurs in non-REM sleep. Okay. So that's it. These are the few differences. So you know that there are different stages of sleep, how they fluctuate, their pattern, how frequent they occur, what is their time period. They are all comes under a sleep cycle. And whatever diagram which I'm showing you here is a hypnogram, that is drawing of the sleep cycle. W is awake stage. Okay. R is REM stage. N1, N2, N3, very rarely it enters N4. It's a rare, very deep sleep, N4 is. Okay. N1, N2, N3 and N4. What are these? They are non-REM stages 1, 2, 3 and 4. Okay. As you can see, there are many studies which say the sleep cycle averages in between 80 to 110. But standard is 90 minutes in most of the textbooks. Okay. So one sleep cycle is 90 minutes in an average adult. Why I'm saying adult? Because the cycle time may change according to the age. Okay. The cycle, one cycle is from between, you calculate it from one rapid eye movement sleep, okay, one REM sleep to the other REM sleep. So in between these two, we calculate what we call the REM sleep, the sleep cycle. Sleep cycle is in between one REM period to the other REM period. So in between, we call it as a sleep cycle. If an adult is sleeping for about 7 to 8 hours, so within this period, there occurs around 5 sleep cycles. Okay. And among these 5 cycles, let us say 1, 2, 3, 4, 5. So the middle ones, like between 2 and 3, they are the longer cycles. Okay. As the night goes on, the REM percentage increases. Okay, in a cycle, normally it constitutes around 20 to 30%. So the maximum amount of REM sleep occurs as the night goes by. Okay, so this is one thing about sleep cycle. And in N1, what happens? The person is just drowsy or is almost awake and falling asleep. And at this time, the desynchronization of the EEG waves, they start occurring. N2 is a stage where there is a light sleep. And there will not be any eye movement now. Brain frequency and the muscle tone is decreased. And slowly the heart rate and body temperature, it goes down. When it comes to N3 or even N4, the most difficult stage is to be awakened. So when you wake up a person during this light sleep stages, the person can awake. But in N3 and N4, it is difficult to awake them. So at this point of time, everybody is now relaxed. Breathing and BP and body temperature are reduced to the core. Okay. So the time, the percentage contribution I already mentioned. Okay. That's not an issue. Next is, what is the variations of sleep with age? Try to look at the image. So REM, this is REM sleep and this is non-REM sleep. Relative contribution by the REM sleep, it goes on decreasing with the age. Okay. And in infants and newborn, as you can see, like almost 50% is REM. Almost 50% is REM. And when it comes to the duration of the sleep, newborns, they sleep for 18 to 20 hours, but older persons, they sleep only 5 to 7 hours. So as we age, the duration of the sleep decreases. The contribution by the REM sleep also comes down. Okay. Non-REM is the predominant component. And when you look at the infants, the cycle of the infants is not 90 minutes. It is 50 to 60 minutes. Okay. We'll compare infants with adult. Okay. We'll tabulate it. Infants and adults. And infants, it is, the cycle is 50 to 60 minutes and it is 90 minutes. And infants, the duration of the sleep is 18 to 20. In adults, it is 7 to 9 hours. And in infants, the sleep straight away begins with REM. Whereas in adults, sleep starts with NREM and it slowly goes into REM. Okay. Even in adults also, the sleep can begin with REM in case of jet lag or if the person is chronically sleep deprived. In those cases, sleep begins with the REM, but usually it begins with NREM in adults. So these are the variations of sleep cycle with age. So now we are entering into the main topic, that is, what are the EEG, electroencephalogram changes? These are the normal adult brain waves, as you can see. When a person is awake with mental activity, the person is awake now. The person will have beta waves. And their frequency is mentioned here. These are all low amplitude, high frequency waves. And they are in a synchronized manner. So these are the beta waves. When the person is awake and when he closes his eyes, okay, there will be slight increase in amplitude and slight desynchronization is starting. But still it is almost similar to the beta wave. So what is coming down? Frequency is coming down, but amplitude is increasing. Please remember this. So we remember it this way. Gay, bat, dance. So first, we have gamma with very high frequency, the EEG waves, which we won't be discussing here. Next is beta. Next is alpha. Next is theta. Last one is delta in deep sleep. So as these move from beta to alpha to theta to delta, what happens? The frequency comes down and amplitude increases. Just observe the waves. That is what is happening, I think. The frequency is more, but amplitude is less. Slight desynchronization. Amplitude is increasing and frequency has come down slightly. But when the person is sleeping, suddenly the theta waves are arising. The desynchronization has started and the amplitude is high. And in deep sleep, we have very high amplitude and low frequency waves. See? These are the waves. The frequency is coming down. You know the mnemonic and how they look. You can easily draw them now. But now go into the more details of what is the, like how it looks, what is its characteristic, and in which stage of sleep, what kind of waves are seen. Now we are going into the more details of it. As you can see, when a person is awake with open eyes, like we are doing, now you are listening to my class, okay? So if you're awake and listening to my class, your eyes are open. When I do an EEG on your brain, you will get beta waves. Okay? Synchronized, high frequency, low amplitude waves like this. So these are the beta waves. Next is alpha wave. Alpha wave, what happens? I think this is not desynchronous. They are more synchronous than the other waves. And where they are recorded, these are all not important, but just for the sake of theory and all, they are recorded best at parietal and occipital regions. Slowly, when a person closes, if he is taking rest and closing his eyes, he is not yet into NREM stage. This stage, the patient will have alpha waves, and which are best recorded at parietal and frontal region. When the person enters into light sleep, that is stage 1 NREM, theta waves, they start appearing. Okay. And if he goes into deeper stage, that is stage 2, yes, the theta waves will be there, but theta waves plus the patient will have two wave characteristics or two wave phenomenon, very important. K complexes and sleep spindles. They are seen in stage 2 non-REM. K complexes, you will see sudden increase in wave amplitude. And sleep spindles, you will see sudden increase in wave frequency. Yes, there will be theta waves like this with slight increase in amplitude and slight desynchronization. Theta waves will be there. But suddenly, at one point of time, you will see very high amplitude waves, and at some point of time, you will see very high frequency waves, which are interspread between the theta waves. So these are K complexes and sleep spindles, which are characteristic of stage 2 NREM. And in stage 3 NREM sleep, we have delta waves, which are slowest with highest amplitude. Stage 3 and stage 4, as I told you, are deep sleep waves. In stage 3, you will see less than 50% delta waves with plus theta. In stage 4, you will see more than 50% delta waves. Okay. And the last one is REM sleep. Okay. In REM sleep, just remember that it is equal to awake stage. Okay. It is equal to awake stage. So there is one more entity which needs discussion. Off late, along with the EEG waves, there is a special wave called pontogeniculo-occipital waves. What is the importance of this special wave called pontogeniculo-occipital waves? See, they are specific to eye movements, and when you can detect these pontogeniculo-occipital veins, the starting of these waves is a reflection of starting of REM sleep. Okay, they are very prominent just before the REM sleep. So I can say PGO wave significance is it is the first sign of REM sleep. And how they are, where they are recorded? They are recorded from pons, lateral geniculate nucleus, and occipital cortex regions of the brain. And these are the areas where these waveforms, they originate. So they originate from the pons, they move to the lateral geniculate nucleus, which is in the thalamus, and they finally end up in the primary visual cortex of the occipital lobe. And the appearance of these waves is most prominent just before the REM sleep. So it's a first sign of REM sleep. So this will conclude our discussion on the EEG patterns. Last slide is about the sleep disorders. So these are the few important sleep disorders that you need to know. One is narcolepsy, that means excessive daytime sleepiness. It is associated with cataplexy, that means sudden loss of muscle tone and paralysis of the voluntary muscles, and also hallucinations, that is hypnagogic hallucinations. Before falling asleep, there will be some hallucinations. We call this as pre-sleep dreams. And there is also automatic behavior, like doing something automatically and not remembering afterwards. So these are the things. Next is NREM and REM. NREM is somnambulism, that is there are some sleep disorders which are specific to non-rapid eye movement sleep, and there are some sleep disorders which are specific to REM sleep or paradoxical sleep. What are the diseases specific to NREM? It is somnambulism, that is walking while sleeping, and also sleep terrors or night terrors, and bedwetting, that is enuresis, and bruxism, that is tooth grinding, and also restless leg syndrome. All the sleep disorders, they commonly occur in non-rapid eye movement sleep. What about REM or rapid eye movement sleep? REM sleep behavior disorder is the one, nightmares and catatrenia. So what is REM sleep behavior disorder? There will be muscle paralysis in this disorder, which is either incomplete or absent, and there will be acting out of dreams that are vivid, intense, and violent. So these dream enacting behaviors are talking, yelling, punching, kicking, and sitting, etc. Okay. And what about nightmares? These are frightening dreams that occur during REM sleep, and they are associated with tachycardia, tachypnea, and profuse sweating, and also arousal. What is catatrenia? Catatrenia is kind of breath holding and expiratory groaning which occurs during sleep. Okay. It can occur in obstructive sleep apnea, that is catatrenia. So there is always some confusion between night terror and also nightmare. See, nightmare is a dream which you remember after waking up. Okay. This night terror, you cannot remember. The only thing what happens is, because of this a terror thing, you will wake up suddenly and you don't know what happened. What is the reason you woke up? Only your partner will know that there was some screaming before it. But whatever nightmare, it occurs during REM sleep. So that's the reason there is some memory. Okay. And you can remember it. You can remember this attack of nightmare, but you will never remember the attack of night terror because it occurs during NREM. Okay, so these are the two important things. Next is the repeats part. So we tried to cover the neurophysiological basis of sleep, definition, types, age pattern, adults and children, what are the waves which are seen during deep sleep, architecture of sleep cycle, variations with age, physiology, and in a separate video we also covered the consciousness, define consciousness, what are the areas which are responsible for it and what are the disturbances of consciousness.